Welcome to the Jack Stevens Center, the home of the Little Rock Trojans and the site of so many great moments last season. My pleasure to be alongside second-year athletic director Chase Conk. I remember being in this same spot last year and thinking of the possibilities of the program. Well, we can check an outright conference championship, a Sun Belt tournament championship, a big NCAA tournament win, record-setting attendance. You checked about all the boxes in year one.
Let's keep it going. No, it was a fantastic year, and we got to see all those things happen, but we really got to see our community come to life and back the Little Rock Trojans. So it was a special year, but I think we're just getting started.
Special opportunity for fans tonight to get in on the ground floor for this coming season.
Yeah, you know, you can get in as low as $99. We're selling season tickets tonight. We've got our coaches and our staff in studio. You can call the number that you'll see on your screen, and you can talk to our coaches firsthand, and we can get you a seat here in the Jack.
One thing we can do now is push that rewind button. Kyle Deckelbaum put together a spectacular piece highlighting some of the great moments from last season. Let's take a look.
I can almost see it, that dream I'm dreaming, but there's a voice inside my head saying, you'll never reach it. Every step I'm taking, every move I make feels lost with no direction. My faith is shaken, but I gotta keep trying.
We've descended on a Friday night in the French Quarter as a party here in New Orleans. The question for Little Rock, will they be dancing on Sunday?
There's always gonna be another mountain. I'm always gonna wanna make it move. Always gonna be an uphill battle. Sometimes I'm gonna have to lose. It ain't about how fast I get there. Ain't about what's waiting on the other side.
Little Rock! Little Rock!
It's the climb.
Yeah! Let's get some music.
No, I'm not breaking. These are the moments that I'm gonna remember most. Yeah, just gotta keep going.
March Madness, college basketball. It's a great time for all of us.
It's hard to believe March Madness actually starts tonight, and the Little Rock Trojans are a part of it.
It's gonna be like Ernie trying to guard Shaq.
It's the NCAA tournament, you know what I mean? We're not gonna be, this is new, so we're just kind of, we're coming out swinging.
They've got the chance to do something very special today against Purdue.
We're not losing. We're either gonna win the game or we might run out of time. We might run out of time, but we ain't losing. We are not losing tonight.
Oh my gosh, Sully, was that incredible?
I've been waiting 22 years to hit that one shot.
It feels great, unreal.
It's amazing.
The emotions are high. Anything crazy can happen in March, and they really have.
Experienced some wonderful moments this past year, but our challenge now is to sustain this type of success, and we certainly can do that, and I believe Wes Flanagan is the guy to get it done.
So much fun to look back at what was truly a remarkable season for the Trojans. The challenge for you guys now is to continue that momentum.
Yeah, you know, like I said earlier, I think we're on to something special. We're really on the cusp of doing something special. We grabbed the attention of our community. We grabbed the attention of the nation last year. But all eyes are on what you've done for me lately. And I have all the faith in Coach Flanagan. Obviously, Coach Foley on the women's side has done an outstanding job. We look to get back in the postseason in both squads this season.
I think one of the great things last year is you saw people in this arena that had never seen a Trojan game before.
Yeah, and that was pretty special. And we saw different demographics. We saw people from all across the city and the state. We saw young families. We've got a great family atmosphere building here. We've got the Junior Trojans Club, which caters to the youngsters. All sports package for $50 per kid. We've got season tickets starting at $99. And so it's truly an affordable, family-friendly atmosphere.
All right, the number to call tonight, 324-4357. They're standing by now. You can get your tickets for as low as $99. We'll be back with much more on our Little Rock Basketball Special. Welcome back to our Little Rock Basketball Special. I'm at Parkview High, and I'm joined by new Little Rock Basketball head coach, Wes Flanagan. This had to be your home away from home growing up.
Well, you know, I come back in here today, and obviously I'm having flashbacks right now, standing right next to you.
All right, show me the jewelry. Just flash the jewelry there.
Well, we got these.
Well, they like the blink, yeah, don't they?
We got these in this week, obviously 30-5. Got a little merchandise to make sure that we remember this, and I got a few of these, but obviously, this, you know,
that is nice.
Has another piece.
And right on the front,
puzzle.
It's Little Rock.
Yeah, got a Little Rock on it. And obviously, I'm a Little Rock representative, and I'm proud to be back here, proud to be the coach here, and I take this very seriously.
Right guy at the right time. In your career, you had paid your dues.
Right.
You take over a program on the rise, and I sense that the community here is really excited about having a Little Rock guy running Little Rock's program.
Well, we rebranded Little Rock's team, and you know, it just makes sense to have a guy from our city.
They say the biggest move is making that move just a few feet to the head coach's seat. But
right.
You have good preparation. I mean, you grew up in a family of coach, and you've been around it, and you've worked for a lot of good head coaches.
Right. Well, I've definitely, I got a coaching tree that I come from. You know, I stood there and I watched a guy every day who was my role model, and my dad, who's all Hall of Fame coach. And so I've been taught the right and wrong things to do. I've learned from a lot of different situations. I've been to Nebraska, I've been in Mississippi State, I've been in UAB, I've been here at Little Rock.
And the good thing for you, you come at a good time as far as talent in the state, and you're going after guys. two guys this year, Andre Jones was our player of the year at Channel 7.
Right.
Ryan Pippins was a huge factor. Your dad won another championship.
Right.
And you've got some commitments you can't talk about, but you're going after the best players.
Well, I've always took great pride in going out and giving guys from Arkansas opportunity to play college basketball. Everywhere I've been, I've had guys from Arkansas on our roster. And that won't change, especially with me being the head coach now. It's great that, you know, we have a pool of guys here in Arkansas in the next two or three classes that have a wealth of talent, and I want to keep as many of those guys in our uniform as possible.
You take a look, if you look up, say, one of these championships and see your name, does it cycle back memories, 1990, 91, the guys you played with?
And, definitely.
How much fun it is now looking back?
Definitely.
You know, Jeff Harris is a friend of mine now that, you know, was on that team with me in the same class that I was the best man in his wedding. You know, I go back, I think about Alfred Warren, who is now a pastor here in Little Rock. You know, Anthony Cap Edwards.
Yeah.
You know, just a lot of guys, man. And again, it goes back to just having, you know, really good guys. And we had those guys here at Parkview. And those are the type of guys I want to recruit at Little Rock, and that's the goal.
Always a pleasure, Coach. And
thank
the
you.
Number to call for tickets is 324-2357. One more look there at the. We want to add more jewelry this year. They look. Players love the bling, don't they?
I want to see you guys in the Jack. Another great year, Little Rock's team. Looking forward to doing some big things again.
How we doing, gang? Any sales?
Roll.
Billy, are you an athlete?
What?
Yeah.
Yes, yes. Any sales?
Not in the last 5 minutes.
Any?
Got one earlier.
Did you really? I think sales are up this year.
Yeah, I think so.
What
is her? Yeah, I'm fine.
Hearing the news that Wes Flanagan had become the new head coach was more than breaking news for me. We were teammates in high school at Parkview High School. You know, we essentially kind of grew up together. And to hear Wes become named the new head coach of our program, there was a level of pride and I think confidence that our program was in good hands, that it was going to be cared for by someone that grew up in Little Rock, that believes in our city. And so I'm happy for Wes. I'm extremely happy for our city that, Wes, as a Little Rock man, is now coaching Little Rock's team. And I'm looking forward to what he can do for our program.
Always great to hear from Fish. The number to call, 324-4357. A chance to see two great teams. The Hall of Fame women's coach, you've done an incredible job building a mid-major powerhouse here at Little Rock. How valuable, Joe Foley, is that home court advantage?
Oh, it's huge. When you got Texas A&M, Oklahoma, and those people coming in, it gives you an opportunity. We had the Texas last year here, so it's just been great for us.
This is something you dreamed about, getting support like this. You've been here 13 years, and it's finally a reality.
Yes, it is. And, we had multiple sellouts last year, and, it's going to carry over this year. The men's got six seniors back. They got Wes from Parkview, so everything's going in the right direction.
All right, the number to call. Congratulations on your success. 324-4357. Solomon Bozeman needs a call. You can relive one of the great moments in Little Rock basketball history. How's the traffic been, Solomon?
Traffic's been pretty good today. Got a lot of calls.
And you are now an assistant coach.
Yes.
There we go. We got a call. 324-4357. Tickets for men's and women's games as low as $99 for season tickets. Now we're going to check in with Kyle Deckelbaum. He is with two Trojan roommates. Check out their relationship.
Well, Sully, here we go with two guys that should play pretty good roles on the team this year, Stetson Billings and Jalen Jackson. And these are two Arkansas guys, two of seven Arkansas guys on the team this year. What's that like to play with all these Arkansas guys, Stetson?
Man, it's a great feeling, keeping it in-state guys, being able to just, come together.
At what point, let's go back to last year, at what point do you kind of come down from the high of that win in the NCAA tournament, Jalen?
Well, pretty soon. Like, soon as we get back for the summer, Coach Flynn kind of told us that last year is over. We already didn't celebrate it enough. It's time to get back serious or whatnot.
You guys know each other very, very well because you were talking about playing with all these Arkansas guys here. Well, you guys were even on the same AAU team. You were both in the wings, right? What do you remember about that?
Man, I miss it a lot. I know that.
So you met in eighth grade, and not only were you on the same AAU team, you guys now are even roommates. Is that possible to coexist and live together when you go up against each other in practice?
Yeah, it is.
That's easy to say. How many times have it been fisticuffs and, when he doesn't do the dishes?
Sometimes I have to straighten them up, but that's all good. It's all love.
Again, what about the time I body slammed in the hotel room?
I don't remember that.
Oh, okay.
So it sounds like he's winning.
He could think that in his mind.
Who's the dirtier roommate?
I stay pretty clean, it don't really be too much stuff going on, but I would say that sometimes my room do get into a little mess, but I get it clean though.
But for the dishes, really don't cook too much. Mostly buying out,
I mostly eat out. He sometimes cook, have the dishes dirty, but
smell
he clean.
Good, don't it?
It's all right, it's all right.
You ever cook for each other?
I haven't tried it yet.
Yeah, would you trust his cooking?
I don't know. I had to try it out one day.
What are you mostly making, Seth?
Most simple stuff, box macaroni and cheese.
Oh, so you're really a cook.
Pork chops. I fry.
This is saying something if he doesn't trust you making easy that.
But simple stuff, not nothing too difficult, so.
All right, how about this year? What's is it going to be difficult to get back to where you guys were? Because now that you've been there, you know how to do it, Jalen.
Well, I feel like it will. Hopefully, we don't get too complacent and we still have the same mindset we had last year, which is go out and play hard every night.
You guys remember, there were times last year this arena was electric, the way we haven't seen it in a long time. Hoping that's back?
Yes, sir. Hopefully it's back. Hope all our fans come out and support us again this year. Hopefully we put on a show for you again.
That'll be here before we know it this season. Guys, best of luck to you. I appreciate it. Fun with these guys, Jalen Jackson, Stetson Billings. You heard them say it, can't miss action this year at the Stephen Center. The number to call right now for tickets is 324-4357. We're back after this.
Welcome back to our Little Rock basketball special. I'm with Hall of Fame coach Joe Foley. Hey, let's talk about last year. I want to go back to the Arkansas State game. I think it was probably the best atmosphere we've had at Little Rock here. Final minutes, the place is rocking, and your team comes through with a win over what was a very good Arkansas State team. But I thought it was as good as you're going to get for women's basketball in the country, maybe. I mean, it was good.
It was one of those games. You know, it's one of the best games I've ever coached in, and I thought both teams played extremely well. That's what you want out of the two. I thought we were the two best teams in the conference at that time, and I think we showed it at that time. And, you know, the crowd was just awesome. When you get to play in front of a crowd like that, you want to have a great game. And I think the people of Little Rock got to see some of the best women's basketball in the country.
Your schedule, it's a credit to you, your relationships and coaching. I know a lot of guys who like to schedule wins early in the season. That is a brutal non-conference schedule. And the great thing is they're going to get to see some great teams again this season at the Jack Stevens Center.
Well, it is. And that's what I want for our women's basketball team. I want them to be challenged. I want the city of Little Rock to get to see the best teams in the country. I think at Mississippi State probably at that time will be in the top 10. Coach Blair's team is always in the top 20. So when you get to bring in teams like that, the people of Little Rock get to see what women's basketball is really about.
Great thing about Coach Foley, you've been in it a while, you've won a lot of games, but you're still learning. I look over at all the books, and this is an action office. I mean, the learning never stops.
I love it. I love reading about the game. You know, last year, went to Connecticut and spent a couple of days with their staff. Picked up a lot of things naturally. You know, he's a great coach, but you know, you just want to steal from everybody that's proven to be a winner. So every time I get the opportunity to read or learn, go someplace and learn about something, a different way of doing basketball, it either helps me decide, all right, we're doing the right thing, or we need to add this, or we can do this better. So to me, it's just like I tell our players, if we're not trying to improve every day, you might as well just quit.
You buy one ticket, it's for the women and the men. $99, as low as $99 for great basketball, which is unheard of.
Well, you
these
know,
days.
Chase, has followed along with the plan, putting the two programs together. I don't think any fan in the country can see anything better than what they've seen last year. A men's program, their schedule will have to start going up too. The more you win like that, the less opportunities you have to schedule those W's, you know. And I know that Wes, you know, he's a great friend of mine, and I know he's wanting to do the same thing. And, you know, it's going to be great for the people of Little Rock to get to see these two programs play.
Always great to visit with you, Coach. The number to call is 324-4357 for Little Rock tickets. They're standing by at the studio ready to take your call. Welcome back to the Jack Stevens Center. It won't be long before we tip off the season. And I could sit right here for $99 and see how many games?
Almost 30 home games. Wow. And our packages include both men and women. We've got a lot of great opponents coming in here. On the women's side, we've got Texas A&M, Mississippi State. On the men's side, we have Tulsa, in-state games against UCA, UAPB. If you wanted an upgrade, though, Sully, you could get to those chair backs over there. The first seat's $250, and then every additional seat's $100 after that. So it's an affordable option to get a great seat here in the Jack.
Let's go back to last year. Did you ever envision we'd have this type of success?
I knew this program was capable of something special. You know, did we think it was going to happen this fast? I'd be lying if I told you that we thought it was going to happen in year one. But what we were able to do and the enthusiasm, the energy that we were able to put into this program, it has a ripple effect and it impacts the university. It was a great moment, a great march for our entire city. And so all of those things, we're coming into this fall with a lot of momentum and we're hoping to keep it going.
You had a couple of true sellouts. Have you circled a date this year that that's going to be the date this year?
Well, we want to have several more. You know, those nights are big nights, and it's great to see the community come together. But we don't want to ease into the schedule. We want to start off with a bang. We've got Tulsa coming in here on the men's side. I believe that's December the 3rd. We're going to hang the banners. We're going to celebrate the championships that night. So we really are gunning for a sellout that first game. But again, our folks in our community can get in on something special. We're still on the ground floor with this thing, and I really think it's in its infancy. So I encourage the community to get behind us, purchase season tickets, and be a part of something fun and something special.
The phone number to call is 324-4357. Thank you, and thank you for joining us for our annual Little Rock basketball special. Have a great rest of the night.
Yeah, you can do it.